Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to integrate a form with Microsoft Forms and a flow which is created in Power Automate. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So what exactly is a flow in Power Automate? Well, a flow is a series of steps that are automatically run based on a lot of different variables, but one of those variables can be user input. So in this case, when a user submits a response to the form that we've created, we want a series of actions to happen. In this case, we are going to have a contact us form, and we are going to redirect emails based on what department the user wishes to contact. So let's get started creating that. Here I am on office.com. And what I would like to do first is create a form. So if I go over here to the app launcher, I might see forms in here if I've recently used it. But if forms does not appear in this list, go down to all apps and scroll down to forms. So in our case, we're just going to go right here to new form. And my form, I'm going to call it Contact Us. And I would like to ask the user first which department they would like to contact. And I'm going to do that using the choice option right here. Which department would you like to contact? So let's let option one be sales, option two be support, and let's add a third option for customer service for all types of other inquiries. And we are going to require this field right here. Because if we don't require it, we're not going to know who to send the email to. And so let's go down here to add new, and this time add text and say, what is your primary question, issue, concern? And this one should also be required so that there's some body for the email. And we can make this a long answer if you would like, in case you want to let your user type in more information than the small amount of space and the not long answer. So there's our form. So basically, the flow that we are going to create is going to go like this. The user's going to come in and indicate which department they would like to contact. On the back end, we'll know the email for each of those contacts. And then we will send that department whatever the user puts in here as their concern. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. Okay, so now that we have the form side of this, let's go to the Power Automate side of this. I can close out this tab, but I am going to go back to Office. And again, just like forms, I'm going to go up to the app launcher. If Power Automate is here, you can click on it, or you can go to all apps and scroll down to the P's and select Power Automate here. So we are going to create this from scratch. So we're going to go over here to the create option on the menu. And if I scroll up to the top, I can create an automated cloud flow. And you can see that this is triggered by a designated event. And so when I click on that, our designated event is listed right here in the list when a new response is submitted. So I'm going to select that. And then I'm going to call this flow redirect emails, and then I'm going to hit create. Now this is my trigger when a new response is submitted, but what form do I want that new response to come from? If I click down on these options, I can see a few contact us forms that I created in error, but I know the latest one is going to be at the top, so I'm going to select that one. And if you can't get to this and you're getting a sign in button right here, that's because you need to sign in to your Microsoft account. So go ahead and do that, and then you should be able to see the forms that are available to you. So now I'm going to go to my next step. So once a response is submitted, I want to go get the details from that form. So I typed forms up here, and I can see that action down here, get response details. This is going to tell me what the user entered. I know it looks like two steps, but the first one is what form submitted an answer. The second one is what are the responses on that form. So I'm going to go over here and I'm going to go back to the Contact Us form. And then my response ID is going to be the ID of the form from right here. And when I click on that, you can see that this window appears, and this window is called Dynamic Content. That means that this information is coming from somewhere earlier in the flow. And in this case, the response ID here is the unique ID of the form that I want to work with. So I'm going to click that. And now my next step is going to be something called a control, and I'm going to select a condition. So this is where Power Automate gets really interesting. If I click in here, I can choose a value. And you can see the dynamic content is coming from my form. So I would like to go to who would you like to contact? And I want this condition to be when a user selects who would you like to contact, and it is equal to sales. And when someone has selected sales, you see the yes right here. Yes, someone has selected sales. I'm going to add an action. And that action is I'm going to send an email. So if I select Outlook right here, I can see what my email options are. So I'm going to click send an email. And who am I going to send it to? Well, I'm going to send it to my sales department, but right now I need to send it to my email so we can do a test and we can see that it works. But when you're doing this scenario, just make sure it's going to your sales department email. So in my case, I'm just going to type in my test account. So in my subject, I'm going to include the option that the user picked. So I'm just going to click on who would you like to contact. And down here in the body, I'm going to scroll down and go to the dynamic content for describing your question, issue, concern. So you can see I have the first part of sales, and sales will get this email. So let's keep going with our flow for the next two options that your user may want to contact. I'm going to go down here to new step, and I'm going to add another condition. And this time, let's pick who would you like to contact as support. And go down here in the yes category and add an action. And we're going to again pick Outlook and send an email. And there probably is a support email, but again, just to test this, I'm going to put in my email. And for the subject, I'm going to pick the option that the responder put in. And for the body, I'm going to pick the description of the question that the user has. And so I'm going to do one more new step and do this as one more condition. And this time it's where who would you like to contact is equal to customer service. And I'm going to add the same action for the third time down here where I pick Outlook, send an email, again, send it to me, have the subject be the choice that the user selected, and have the body be their issue or concern. Okay, so those are our steps of our flow. Let's go over it one more time. When someone submits a new response, we're going to get the details of that response. If the department they would like to select is sales, we're going to send an email to sales. If the department they would like to pick is support, we're going to send an email to support. And if the department they want to contact is customer service, we'll send the email to customer service. So I'm going to save this, and then I'm going to go back to Microsoft Forms. And I'm going to click this button that says collect responses, and I'm going to copy the link to my form. Now I'm going to go up to my address bar and just paste that link. So let's fill out three of these. The first one goes to sales and hit submit. I'm going to paste that link again in my address bar and hit enter. This one will go to support, and I'm just going to say support in my issue. And then I'll paste that one more time here and fill out a third form for customer service and say customer service here and hit submit. So now if I go back to office.com and I click on Outlook, One email has been sent to me for sales, one for support, and one for customer service, exactly in the order that I had filled out those forms. So hopefully this gives you an introduction to some of the possibilities using Microsoft Forms alongside Power Automate. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. As always, thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.